Another one. Go find your own grave, you rotten fool.
Windle?
Windle? Good. That's my private name. Ah, you still remember, lad? Oh, great days they were. Great days. Life? You don't know what life is until you're dead. It was great. All that breathing and walking around in the fresh air. Oh, I tell you, if I had my time all over again, I wouldn't reincarnate.
So, how are you adjusting then?
Oh, I'll never get used to this grave, I'll tell you. The walls are so thin. All you can do here is lie around and listen to what the neighbours say.
So, what's it like? Being dead, I mean.
Oh, I've had enough of it. The hours are too long for a start. Here, keep the wretched dead and alive hole.
Wait, what am I supposed to do with a grave?
Use it as a small swimming pool, huh?
I can't swim.
I never said you had to fill it with water, did I? Yikes and away.
Right. Well, it looks like I have a real mission then. I either restore death to his rightful place, or else we'll be up to our armpits in gaunt, dark-eyed young gothic girls dressed in black, all pretending that they can quote romantic poetry. Actually, that doesn't sound bad at all. Nah. Onward! You again.
He says, hello, how are you? And shouldn't you be getting a move on and get death back on his feet?
That's very clever. Where did you come from?
You'd have to ask my mother and father. They never tell me. That's just a familiar little joke.
Yeah, a very familiar little one. That's just a little bit of sarcasm.
You just wait until I get my own body back, young man. I'll give you sarcasm.
If I'll ever be able to shake it off.
Yeah.
Exactly alike, precisely as specified.
Oh, very good. What did you do then? Just go and get some sticks from the garden?
Well, I never.
Well, obviously you did.
There you go. Bet you thought a mouse didn't hold that much blood.
How exactly... No, never mind. Some things are best left unknown.
Here you are, one vile stench.
What's this then? Looks more like a genie in a bottle.
You'll get a lot more than you wish for if you open it. Dust for your perusal.
Ah, right you are, my boy. Excellent. We'll make a junior apprentice wizard out of you yet.
But I'm already an assistant wizard, third class.
The day is still young.
They feel all nice and dribbly. Here we are, genuine dribbly candles. And it wasn't only the bees that sweated getting these.
Not strictly necessary, but I suppose they'll look nice.
Well, that's it then. That's 3 sticks of wood, 4 cc's of mouse blood, glitter, stench, and dribbly candles.
Really? What for?
For the rite of Ash Kent. You said we needed it. I spent ages getting the right stuff.
Ooh, I don't think so. For that one, you need to open the book, light the bell, and ring the candle. Or was it light the book, open the bell, and ring the candle? Something like that. Is off you go. We need a candle, a book, and a bell.
You're not serious, are you?
Of course not. I just love watching the pathos crossing your helpless little face. Come on, let's get these sticks and dribbly candles and do this Ash Kent thing, shall we?
Gonna summon death here, then have jelly for our afters.
Daylight!
Oh, good grief.
Didn't quite come out as planned, did it?
Who started us off on this?
Look, I worked long and hard to get this stuff. Can we at least treat this ceremony with a little bit of... Damn it, I've lost my train of thought now. What's that word I was looking for? The one used for describing distinction. Differentiation of treatment.
Repression?
No, it's not going to be repression, is it? We can't treat a ceremony with a sense of repression.
Dictatorship of the proletariat?
What?
The dictatorship of the proletariat. That results as an inevitable reaction against repression.
Look, I think this would work better if everyone just got back on track. It's time we acted with a little bit of class.
Class, that was it. The word was class.
What word?
I don't know, but I'm sure it was important.
What was?
How long have you been here, then?
Since the banana. Will this take long? I'm on holiday. It's good here. Sun, sheep, sand, hats with corks, no worries. I'm supposed to have a chunder in a minute.
A chunder? What's a chunder?
You know, I'm not sure, but it sounds interesting.
Now look here, you. This city is in chaos. I mean, how dare you go swanning off to foreign lands while we're up to our armpits in undead? Now you... You get right back here and get back to work.
Work? I don't remember any work. All I remember is a great big bang. Then an eternity of beer. And no worries, mate.
Lucky blighter.
Now I've had about enough of this. You get off that thingamy, get those corks out of your hat, and... What? Now, just you come back here. I have a plan.
Oh, no.
Rincewind, lad! How wonderful to see you looking so well, so very sprightly, so very, shall we say, so very mobile.
You want me to go find out where death has gone?
Oh, only if you don't want to spend the rest of your life staring out across a pond at all the other toads.
Frogs?
If you prefer.
If we had a proper union like the alchemists do, I'd have a few harsh words for you.
Like a dictatorship of the,
Oh, shut up.
Act 2. Come die with me. Futures. Probably no other world in the multiverse has warehouses for things which only exist in potentia. Here, however, The Pork Futures Warehouse is a product of the patricians' rules about baseless metaphors, the literal-mindedness of citizens who assume that everything must exist somewhere, and the general thinness of reality around Ankh. The net result is that trading in pork futures, in pork that doesn't exist yet, led to the building of the warehouse to store it until it does. The extremely low temperatures are caused by the imbalance in the temporal energy flow.
Standing about here all day when the cosmos is going down the privy. Hey, I think I'm getting the hang of this.
Just fancy. 20 years of school and finally you've mastered the ability to talk to a rat. Your mother must be so very proud. If you ever had a mother.
Bring out your dead. Luxury post-mortem transportation services, five-star service, best cadaver relocation agency in Ankh Morpork. Highly recommended service. Bring out your dead.
So, where do you transport your corpses?
Oh, well, it used to be all mountains, you know, scenic locations. Very cold, you see, so the customers enjoyed it for longer before all their bits fell off. But you should see the place we've just found now, sir. Beaches, hats with corks, and blondes with these huge, straining, pink, oil-smeared...
Yes, but how do I get there?
Well, you'd have to be dead, sir. We've got the entire season's passages already booked.
Look, are you telling me that I have to be dead in order to qualify for tourist travel?
Well, yes, sir, but it's a very reasonable option. We let you take all the luggage you want.
Why is that?
It's all classed as carrion baggage, sir. That was just another little undertaker's joke.
It's a good thing you have a captive audience. Why not just tell me how to get to this holiday location of yours?
Just a death certificate should do it, sir. It's the only way to tell these days. Got one, have you?
Let's just stop all this now. One get to be declared dead round here?
Simple, sir. Just lay down on that slab. When a cold mirror won't cloud with your body's breath and there's no detectable pulse, then we can safely declare the individual to have passed beyond.
Even if they're still walking and talking?
I've had to relax those criteria, sir. In the current situation, it pays to be flexible in your definitions.
See you later. If it's low body temperature he wants, then it's low body temperature he'll get. Look, I'm feeling a little bit dead. And so I thought I'd better just pop along and see you.
Right. A very wise decision, if I may say so, sir. Now, we'll do a few little standard tests. Firstly, I'll check your breath, see if it clouds up this mirror. Okay, now I'll check your arm for a pulse. Looking good so far, sir. Just one last test. Your body temperature.
No, wait! Perhaps we can talk about this! Yow!
Wonderful news, sir. Wonderful news.
Yes? Am I dead?
As a doornail, sir. Finally, a satisfied customer at last. Now then, here's a death certificate, which also entitles you to cut price headstone carving, embalming, and free drinks at the yearly Mortician's Ball.
Mortician's Ball? Doesn't sound like much fun to me.
Oh, you know, sir, once the old embalming fluid starts flowing, of course it kills you in the end, but what doesn't, eh? Well, have a nice death. And please don't hesitate to call round again if there's anything I can do for you.
We'll soon have you off to a post-mortem holiday. Did I tell you the one about the carrion luggage?
Afraid so.
Ah, well, can't win them all, or any of them, come to think of it.
Arr, yo-ho-ho, me matey. Shiver your timber, a vast improvement.
Stop that.
Oh, please. It's genuine nautical gibberish.
No, I've told you about that. I'm only doing business with you if you stop all that ridiculous yo-ho-ho business. It's demeaning.
But it's establishing character.
No, it's establishing that you are a loony. This is supposed to be a sea voyage, not Captain Sea Dog's little shipmate's holiday fun club.
Look, if we're going to sea, then we ought to establish ourselves as acceptable stereotypes of sea-going characters. It all stands to reason. Now, you can't hold me responsible for the paradigms which grip our customers. They expect this sort of thing. They don't think you're real without all that avast a main brace business. Word-of-mouth advertising can make or break a business like mine.
Word-of-mouth? They're dead!
Oh. Oh, all right. Just bring them on board then and we'll forget all about it.
What?
Nothing. Just, clearing my throat.
There's something very odd about you.
As I were walking down Paradise Street, singing hey ho, a blow the man down, a saucy young cuttlefish I chanced there to meet. Oh, give me some time to blow the sheep up. Damn!
I say, any chance of a cup of tea, my nautical arty?
Arr! That's the ghost of Captain Lavenderbeard, back from Davy Jones's bathroom. Run for your lives, women and fearless sea dogs first.
You know, I seem to meet more crazy people in sheer coincidence should I now. Anyway, looks like I'm in control now. There you are. Bone idle, I see. Come on, get up and get back to work. It's chaos back there.
No. I like it here. It's a land of opportunity. Sun, surf, and prawns.
I can see the sand's giving you a nice bleach. Come on, we're going home.
No, I'm not going back. I worked my fingers to the bone for them, but they all hate me.
Hate you? What does that matter? You're dead. You're not supposed to worry about things. You just happen.
Well, I want more from life. A little bit of popularity. It's not too much to ask, is it? I work hard for everybody. Does anyone ever say thank you? I think not.
Thank you for dying? Look, if I promise you that I'll find a way of making you popular, will you come back?
People will like me. You promise?
Cross my heart and hope to meet you in your professional capacity. Now, is it a deal?
All right. But only if you make me feel wanted.
I have just the thing to bring the message into the people's hearts and minds, my dear fellow. Tell me, have you ever heard of something called the clickies?
A clicky, you say? Something to make a legendary figure more personally popular? That's a challenge and a half, that is. But nothing modern marketing techniques can't handle. You just leave it to old Dibbler.
All right, but I want it to have integrity. Just make it nice.
Nice? Of course it'll be nice. I'll tell you what, I'll splice you in for half a take, but mind, I'm cutting my own throat. Now, tell me what talent you got lined up. This lead of yours. Nice, upper balcony, is she?
No.
Oh, well, what a skinny one then, eh? Long and lean, eh? Whoa.
Well, quite lean, yes.
I've got it then. I've got the angle. Works as a shipwright by day over at the docks. Sweat, 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 wood shavings, and torn, tight little shirt. And then dances in an exotic nightclub every evening. We clap a soundtrack on it and we got a hit for sure.
A shipwright who dances in a topless bar? What the hell do you take our audiences for?
For about £3 a ticket, why? What's wrong? The formula's perfect.
I'm just not so sure my principal lead is gonna make a very convincing exotic dancer. I mean, sex-wise and all.
You mean they're a man?
Well, I suppose he's a man. It's hard to tell, really. You have to look at the pelvis, don't you?
They keep you wizards indoors too long. That's your problem, mate. Look, I'll tell you what. We can sell anything, just as long as we have the right marketing. You know the product, so I'll leave all that with you. We need three things to make this a success. You've been waiting for this bit, haven't you? Just waiting for it. First and foremost, a gorgeous babe. That's just pro forma for the press. Next, you need a really catchy jingle, a song we can clap into the soundtrack. Finally, we need a gimmick, a novelty merchandise that actually creams the cake. Get me those three things, and I'll have a film out in no time.
Collect a babe, a jingle, and some novelties. I don't suppose you'd consider collecting them yourself.
Nah, mate. What sort of fool would waste his valuable leisure time voluntarily going off on annoying little quests set by stupid and ungrateful people, eh?
Yes, he'd have to be some sort of idiot, wouldn't he? Oh well, see you in a little while then. Take axe, open door, kill dragon. Why wasn't I born in the days of text adventures?
Chitty grubs, a bonza feed. You can just smell them on the barbie now, eh? Come on, the cost's only 3 bits, and at this price, I'm cutting me own didgeridoo.
No, look, I don't want to eat any insect larva today, thank you.
Could be the mistake of your life, mate. They're yummy.
Yeah. grubs? Ew, they smell awful.
You'd be really grateful for a feed of these if you were lost in the desert, mate.
A good advert for buying a map, I feel. Are you sure you live here? You seem awfully familiar to me.
Sure as a platypus is an egg-laying mammal. Now, can I interest you in any quality dinkum merchandise, mate? Picnic hampers? Hats with corks? How's about a nice bent stick? I've got a lovely line in those.
No, now look, why don't you sell anything useful?
Useful? It's all useful. See? Here, best thing for that, take a couple of raw insect larvae, cures it like magic.
Like magic?
Well, if it cures it, it'll be magic. Come on, mate. Two for the price of one. I'm cutting me own bludger.
Go away. Baskets. Take a good look. You'll probably be weaving these in remedial therapy before you finish this game. This picnic hamper, it's not filled with bugs or anything, is it?
Nah, mate. I'd charge extra for the bugs. It's a bargain. I'll give you the handle for free, but I'm cutting me own billabong.
Very nice.
Yes, yes.
Nah, I don't like it. Oh no, it's awful. You know what that needs? It needs a good gelding.
Quite right. Whip them off and we'll soon see a difference.
Yes.
Time was they'd only let real men in here.
They'll let any old rubbish in these days.
Yes.
Mystic temptresses of the East. Not quite as I imagined them, actually. So why do they get such good press? I suppose they must have a good publicity machine.
Popping humours.
Candy rock straight from Big Rock Candy Mountain. Oh, look! Apparently, the stuff
Popping
comes in coal tar, sulfur, and new phosphate flavours.
Popping hummus. Genuine popping hummus. Take it home and do it yourself. I let it go at half price, even though I'm cutting my own hand off. Off. Or relics. Relics of Fendi. Brand new relics, only half a dinar.
New relics? How can you have new relics?
Through the magic of pyramid power, Fendi. Through the effects of time distortion, we now can bring you all the prestige of ancient artifacts without the annoyance of having broken old rubbish cluttering up the house.
So what's all this about pyramid power, then?
My esteemed dress-bedecked one. The pyramids are mystic centers of great power. Within them, time is slowed, or time is sped. And they also sharpen hamburger and keep razor blades fresh. Ha ha! Four functions for the price of one. Yours for a desert song, Effendi. 1,000 dinar! And hey, I'm cutting my own hand off.
No, thank you. I'm trying to give them up. Goodbye for now. You're a rather rock-loving sort of fellow. Do you have any candy, Rock?
What, like trolls eat and lose all their teeth on? Yup, there's a slab of it just here. It's terrifically popular. Well, you can throw it at someone and no one gets hurt, see? Good stuff for stonings. I mean, you get to stone the victim all over again on another day.
So this candy, Rock, can I have it then?
Oh, certainly. I mean, why bother even paying any money? I'm just glad to be of help.
Yes, yes, yes.
Sorry about that, sir. It's just supply and demand. Maybe you should try the next stoning. It should only be in a full moon or two. Someone's sure to have done something stonable by then.
I can't wait for two full moons. I'm on a timetable, I am. What am I going to do now?
Have you ever considered, sir, engaging in a long and almost pointless quest to achieve the same results we almost had squared away a mere few seconds ago, sir?
Do I look the sort of person who'd go... I do, don't I? I really do.
Witness the all-powerful mystic-type skills of what would be the Far East if that direction existed here. Watch now as Yuri Geller manipulates the metal objects with the modern powers of his magnificent brain. Strain! 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 Oh, the end has fallen off.
Look, you being a mystic and all, you wouldn't happen to know anything about jingles, would you?
Yuri Geller knows all about jingles. You bring Yuri bells and he will make them jingle. You want big jingle or little jingle?
You'll be hearing bells soon if you don't pay attention. I mean jingle as in short, catchy song. Some meaningless little tune that goes around and around in your head all day.
Ah, now Yuri understands. You mean like philosophy, but... to music.
Yeah, that's the one.
Yes, Yuri knows a philosopher. He in desert. Yuri, try and remember. Strain. 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 Yuri, please to be of assistance. Witness the all-powerful mystic-type skills of what would be the Far East if that direction existed here. Watch now as Yuri Geller manipulates the metal objects with the modern powers of his magnificent brain. Strain! 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 Oh, the end has fallen off.
All right, so what do you do?
Yuri Geller uses the power of the mind to restart hourglasses and to bend and unbend the metal things and to find out tomorrow's news today.
So does it work?
Yuri also has a special skill at putting things on top of other things.
How lovely for you. All right, what about these other mystic powers, then?
We have their fabulous pyramid powers of time and space. We have the mystic men sitting in deserts. And we have cut-rate camels. Although they're not quite so mystic, but they can't half spit.
Oh, really? Is that all?
You want more? Then we have the fountain of youth. Yes, indeed, you can get a second childhood without all the dribbling and unfortunate bad-type smells.
Now that sounds more like it. Where might I find that?
I've forgotten.
When they call your people fakers, they're not joking, are they?
How dare you cast aspersions on my mighty powers of, what's it called? It was on the tip of my tongue. Mine's gone blank. Memory, there is a prospector what comes through here every now and again. He goes everywhere. He's been around for centuries. You ask him if he's ever seen a greater sage than Yuri Geller.
Be seeing you then.
Popping humours.
I say, can you maybe do me a little favour? I have some things here that need straightening out.
No problems, my good man. Strain! 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 Oh, my nose has started to bleed. Now look what you have made me do. All down the front of Dad's good shirt.
Popping humors.
One prime racing gerbils rented to you at lowest cost.
Gerbils? Those look like camels.
No, Effendi. These are gerbils, desert dwelling rodents. Very fine, very cheap.
Look, I'm telling you that these are not gerbils. Do these gerbils of yours eat cheese, run about in little wheels, make nests out of old tissues and cotton wool?
No, Effendi.
So what makes you think that these creatures are gerbils?
They burrow.
Really? All of them?
Yes. Well, no. Not all of them. Well, none. Really.
Right. Well, I might be interested in renting one of the non-burrowing ones, then.
Indeed. Please, feel free to browse.
Right. Let us for now establish that these are camels. This being so, how much to rent one for a brief journey?
5 dinar, Effendi.
And to buy?
5 dinar, Effendi.
Why are they the same to rent as to buy?
I cannot stand the noise they make as they sit in their wood shavings eating cheese.
Now look, I thought we had that settled. Oh, all right. 5 dinar, then. But only if you invest some of it in professional psychiatric treatment.
Yeah.